most metropolises or even the rural areas, actually more in rural areas, has one of these. This is Mira Loma Trailer Supplies and Service, RV Repair, Hitches and Wiring. And they carry a lot of overstock stuff and they sell it for like half price. I'm here to pick up Sidewinder tongue jacks today. And my dog won't be quiet. But I'll do a little video inside. I just want to show you that, you know, you look for places like these in your local area. This is about, 30 miles from me. So when I come here, I try and get a lot of stuff. Kind of, you know, save on gas for trips out here and stuff. So we're going to go inside and I'm going to get my tongue jacks and probably pick up some other stuff too. I've got one of these that I picked up for 25 bucks. It's just like this. Look at this guy. This would go really good in the back of a teardrop, which it's a cast iron stove. Look, it's only 80 bucks. I've seen them online for 300. They've even got used stuff. Look at this, windshield wipers for your RV. So whether you're doing an old trailer or a new one, it doesn't matter. Find a place like this, they've got lots of stuff. They dismantle RVs here too. We got noisy in here. Little parts, gas parts.
You know what I'll do?
A little bit of everything.
And I'll pick up a newspaper.
Need steps? I'm gonna need one. I'm not sure what size yet, but I'm going to need one. I'll be back here. Multi-use hitches. All kinds of neat stuff.
I'm going to pick up a ham tomorrow at Honey Bay.
Here's. There's an older Magic Chef. Nice big fresh water tank. I just noticed this thing. I imagine that's a hood fan. This is a hood. No. Huh. Stuff. Well, 12 volt DC. There's a little toilet. Has its own holding tank, I believe. No, that one needs a holding tank. But there it is. New wheels. This looks like 6 inches. The gray one does. How about one end of an axle? End up going around in circles with this thing. Brakes, whole brake setup. See? Electric brakes, there you go. And here's how they work. There's the magnet, the electric magnet, and that just pulls itself towards the disc and that activates the brakes. So now you know how they work and you can get all the parts here. Everything involving wheel bearings, shackle parts, axle parts, springs. There's all your springs. New and used. New and old, let's put it that way. Not necessarily used, just sitting out in the rain. Hubcaps, ooh. There's your moons, there's your deep moons. Oh my God, $11.95, are you kidding me? There's only one, darn it. If there was two, I'd have bought it. There's smaller moons. Yeah, they only have, here's some mini moons. See? Those are about, what, 7, 8 inches? 8 inches probably. This is the one I that everybody wants, and he's only got one of them. Oh, here they are, up here. Yeah, he's got the cone ones. The cone ones are also like $11.95. Don't know what you're paying at VTS. I'll have to look when I get home. Two of those. Wish I knew the dimensions. He's even got gimp here. That brown? Yeah, that's brown rubber welting. Look at that. Probably buy that whole roll from him. This wheel is a 5-hole. It's a little deep though. The 13 inch, I think. 13 or 14. And it's got the three lips, and this fits it. That fits it. Electrical. A big power inverter. I don't need anything that big. Not for this little Shasta, but that's a nice one. Oh, sorry, that's an inverter. DC to AC inverter. Frequency controlled. Ooh. That means you can hook up your computer to it. Sorry, that's a square wave. So, no, you don't want to hook your... I mean, you can hook your computer up to it, but you don't want to hook up a charger to it. Square wave, not sine wave. Looking for beehives. I don't see any. I got some LED taillights. Okay, I've got everything I want except the refrigeration vent, and he won't have that till next Wednesday, so I get to come back. Alrighty. Now for the painful part. That's okay. Alright, so I got two vents. One is a new, never used vent right here, and that's the one I'll use for the refrigerator on the Shasta. And then I've got an older vent that's basically the same type of vent, but it's the older kind that has the hair-type hinge, just like the windows do. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask the owner which vent they want me to use, either the new one or the old one. I don't care. The other one will go on the Kensco, whichever one they don't pick. I have a funny feeling they'll go for the old one because it matches everything else on the trailer. And on the Kensco, I really don't care because it's newer. Well, it's not newer. It's a 59 also. I also got four brand spanking new 2,000 pound, which is way more than you need, sidewinder. That means that it cranks on the side so that your hand isn't hitting the, you know, the top of the propane tank stuff every time you swing it around. Boy, I got tired of that with the Kensco. So I got one for the Kensco. I got one for that, which is way overkill, but when that thing's loaded up with equipment, then it's not so overkill. I got these two moons, which are for 14-inch wheels, 14 and 13-inch wheels, not for 15s. They won't work on 15s. But so that means I can't use these on the Shasta unless I go to smaller wheels, which I may do. It's got plenty of room in the wheel wells for 15 inch, but we'll see. At least I have them. They're hard to find. They're brand spanking new. They're only 12 bucks each. And I've got this thermostatically controlled fridge vent fan. It determines, you know, the temperature and decides when to come on. So that's a real good thing, because we're going to put a brand new refrigerator in the Shasta, 59 Shasta. So this thing will come on when needed. It needs 12 volts anyway for the refrigerator computer. So I got all this stuff for $197. The four jacks, the two vents, the two hubcaps, and the fan, which is listed as $47.95, but when you look at the receipt and everything, he bundled all this, so I paid less money. I only paid $98, I think, for all four of the jacks. They're basically $27.95 each, as you can see on there. Okay, this was $47.95. The hubcaps are 12 bucks each. You can see that. You saw it earlier. There it's listed. And the vents, and I got it all for $197. Isn't that cool? So yeah, you can find one of these guys in your area. Just have to look around and talk to people and find people in your area that are into the same thing you're into, which is, you know, restoring trailers, whether they be 50s, 60s, 70s, or even 80s. I wouldn't restore anything beyond that because they're not worth it. So there we are. So I've got everything I need now, and you folks can go find one of these yourselves. Larry from Mobile Tech. See you next time.
Be on YouTube.